this our month for in and out visit month, and we will focus in connecting and touching people with the love of Jesus through the visitation and inviting them to the touch event that we are holding. And our scripture memory verse for this week, we could find it in Ephesians 1:18. Let us read together. I ask that your minds may be open to see his light, so that you will know what is the hope to which he has called you, how rich are the wonderful blessings he promises his people. Ephesians 1:18. Our August 3-in-1 guide is now available. Please get one and feast in the Word of God. And this afternoon, we will have our equipping class. The topic is the letter to the Ephesians. It will be after service, 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Please come and be equipped in this equipping class this afternoon. And our water baptism has been moved to August 21. August 21 po, our water baptism for. Let us continue to pray for our brothers and sisters who will be baptized in this event. Cora, Eric, John, and Teofilo Maramba. Let us include them in our prayers. And may I request our brothers and sisters to please stand and let us pray for the needs and concern of our church. Una po, let us pray for ourselves as we hear the word of God today, that we may put it in our hearts and apply it in our daily lives. Second po, let us also intercede sa mga victims po natin sa Philippines na na affected sa earthquake these few days. And also let us pray for ourselves as we receive the message and thank God for all the blessings that he has given us. To each and everyone, especially, we are here, healthy, nakaka-attend po tayo ng ating service every now and then, prayer meeting and everything. And we also include in our prayers for our brothers and sisters na hindi po nakaka-attend ng cell group. Isa na rin po ako doon. I pray na each and every one of us will have a cell group that we will be able to equip in our spiritual life. Let us bow our heads and let us pray for these needs, prayer, and concern. Our Father in heaven, we worship you and we praise you and we thank you, for you are so good to us. Our help comes from you and we will always look on you. Heavenly Father, thank you for in our union with our Lord Jesus Christ, you have given us perfect spiritual gift, and you have blessed us with wonderful blessings. Thank you for, we pray, Lord, that these blessings, this gift, we might use it to spread the gospel in this place, that we may be able to know the plan and purpose of God to bring order and peace in this world. Heavenly Father, we thank you for you are working in our lives, even though we don't see it. We know that you are making good situation from this challenging world. And Father God, we continue to pray for our brothers and sisters who are not here with us. We pray that you continue to lead them and guide them to your ways. To those brothers and sisters who are sick, we pray, Father God, that you continue to touch their body, that your healing hands be upon them, that they will be healed. And we lift also the government of the Philippines, that you may continue to use their given resources to help proper assistance and help to those victims that are affected by the earthquake. And we lift our Pastor Phoebe Lee and Sister Joanne Wei, anoint their lips, and we ask and pray that you give us the spirit of wisdom, that we may know the plan and purpose of God's will, that we may know Him better, that we will grow up spiritually as we go closer to our Lord Jesus Christ. Holy Spirit, we welcome you in this place. Fill each and every one of us, that we may be able to receive, sensitive to your presence. Thank you, Father God, our Creator. Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ, our Redeemer and Savior. Thank you, Holy Spirit, who helps us and who dwells in us. Thank you that you hear our prayers and you answer our prayers. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Let us remain standing and let us open our Bible in the letter of Paul to the Ephesians, chapter 1, verse 15 to 23. Ephesians, chapter 1, verse 15 to 23. Let us read together. For this reason, ever since I heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus and your love for all God's people, I have not stopped giving thanks to God for you. I remember you in my prayers and ask the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the glorious Father, to give you the Spirit who will make you wise and reveal God to you so that you will know Him. I ask that your minds may be open to see His light, so that you will know what is the hope to which He has called you, how rich are the wonderful blessings He promises His people, and how very great is His power at work in us who believe. This power working in us is the same as the mighty strength which He used when He raised Christ from death and seated Him at His right side in the heavenly world. Christ rules there above all heavenly rulers, authorities, powers, and lords. He has a title superior to all titles of authority in this world and in the next. God put all things under Christ's feet and gave Him to the church as supreme lord over all things. The church is Christ's body, the completion of Him who Himself completes all things everywhere. May the Lord add blessing upon the reading of His word. Let us now welcome our Pastor Phoebe Lee and Sister Joanne Wei as they share the message about serving God's power.
Two weeks ago,
my daughter was tested positive for COVID. She had a fever. Actually, it also has also other mild symptoms of flu.
发烧一天而已, huh?
She had fever for a day. And after 3 days, she has recovered.
第二天才测出来她确诊。
It was during the second day that she was tested positive for COVID.
那为了防疫的缘故, 所以我们全家都通通行动, 要受限制, huh?
For the sake of the pandemic prevention, our movements in the family were restricted.
所以我们很多事, 很多事都不能做, huh?
There are so many things that we cannot do anymore.
所以我就学习到一件事, 就是生命当中很多事呢, 不是我们可以掌握的,
so I learned something that there are things in the world, not everything in this world can be controlled by us.
我们可以计划, 但是可能常常会出现变化。
Although we can plan, but sometimes our plans cannot keep up with the changes.
我们常常, 对, 我们全家人在家, 就常常在测那个, the rapid test.
So while we were at home during that time, we always used the rapid test to test ourselves.
因为如果另外一个在确诊, 我们家又要延长那个隔离的时间, huh?
Because if another person in the family is tested positive, then we have to prolong our time of home quarantine. But God is the God of peace.
我不能紧张跟忧虑的过日子, huh?
I cannot live my life worrying and always agitated at all times.
所以每一天我都放心的, 宣告说, 我们家有平安, 把一切的事情交给神。
So I proclaim that we have peace at home and I entrust our family to the Lord.
真的, 我就每一天很平安地做着该做的事, huh?
So every day I experience peace doing what I'm supposed to.
每天在打扫, 在清洁消毒, huh?
Cleaning up the house, sterilizing.
然后每天都感谢神,
and thank God every day.
因为每一天我们测, 我们都是阴性的,
because
huh?
We tested negative every day.
然后结果我们全家都很平安,
and then we experience our family experience peace.
那我本来很心疼我女儿生病啊,
at first I feel a bit distressed about my daughter getting sick.
结果女儿跟我说, 妈妈我很感恩,
but my daughter said, Mom, you know I'm thankful.
因为她说, 因为我可以好好地休息,
because I can finally rest for a period of time.
她什么都没有做, 但是却有很多人来关心她。
Actually she did nothing at all, but many people came to show their concerns.
她还收到一大箱的什么防疫物资,
she also received a big box of supplies from OICUS, what we call pandemic box care.
所以她很高兴地发给我们每个人吃,
and she was happy to share all this food inside the box.
而且每一天都有人, 她每天都要接电话, 因为每天都有人打电话来关心她。
There'll be people calling her up every day, showing the concerns.
那她本来有很多的计划,
at first she has a lot of plans,
因为她是 youth worship 的 worship leader, pianist.
She's the worship leader in the youth ministry, and also youth worship is also the pianist.
然后我儿子是鼓手,
my son is the drummer in the youth ministry.
所以他们的那个 youth, 那他是那个 PowerPoint, 我儿子也是那个什么直播童工,
and also another person is responsible for the audio for the OHP.
所以他们必须开很多线上会议, huh?
So they have to hold meetings online because of this.
And now 他也是 Sunday school 的 co-teacher.
And another is a co-teacher in the Sunday school.
所以就看他很忙, huh?
So I see my kids very busy at home.
然后特别感恩就是他没有喉咙痛。
But I thank God my daughter didn't suffer from sore throat.
所以她可以讲电话。
She can still talk over the phone.
我突然有一个很深的体会,
all of a sudden I have this deep understanding.
如果我要很害怕的, 过这几天,
if I'm going to spend these few days worrying and being very fearful,
那我们全家都会活得很紧张,
and then we would all be very nervous spending these 7 days of quarantine.
可是我每一天都把主权交给神,
but every day I give the lordship of our lives to God.
确诊我会感谢他,
even if we get infected, we still thank God.
没有确诊也是感谢他,
if we're not infected, we still thank God.
因为我相信我们这一生都有恩惠慈爱随着我们,
because we believe that the Lord's grace and goodness would accompany us all the days of our lives.
亲爱弟兄姐妹啊,
so dear brothers and sisters,
你一定要记住啊,
you have to remember this.
威胁你的不是新冠肺炎的病毒,
it's not the COVID virus that threatens your life.
It's
fear that intimidates you.
所以你要来到神面前,
so you have to come to the Lord's presence,
向他献上感谢和赞美,
and give thanks and praises to him.
说感谢主，我谢谢你在我生命当中许多的恩典跟保护。
Lord, I thank you for your protection and for your many blessings in my life, and I praise you.
你比新冠病毒更有能力。
Because you are far greater than COVID virus.
你的平安随着我们。
And your peace will accompany us.
所以很感恩，我就经历到了哈。
So I thank God I experienced His peace during that time.
那我们今天要从我们要从今天的这段经文来学习。
Today I'd like to learn from the scripture we read a while ago.
那我们怎么样获得能力，然后来服侍神
？How we can be empowered to serve God?
啊，其实在这刚刚我们读的经文之前呢，在以弗所书第一章的前半段。告诉我们说我们是有福气的人。
Actually from the passage that we read a while ago, the previous context speaks about us being a people of with God's blessings.
那他说我们在基督里面有各样的天上各种属灵的福气。
We have different kinds of blessings in heaven and earth.
因为我们是被拣选的。
Because we've been chosen.
然后我们是圣洁没有瑕疵。
We are holy, we are blameless.
然后我们有儿子的名分。
We have the title as children of God.
我们被救赎，我们的罪被赦免。
We are saved, our sins are forgiven.
然后我们会知道神的旨意。
And we would know God's will.
好，这是上帝给我们的。
This is what God has given us.
然后呢，再下一个，好，下一个 PowerPoint。 他说我们是在耶稣基督里面，我们是有产业的。
And it also says that we have an inheritance in Christ Jesus.
那我们来读一下这个，哎 Next slide. And next. 好，我们来读这个13-14节。
Let's read this passage, Ephesians chapter 1, verses 13 to 14 altogether. When you heard the message of truth, the gospel of your salvation, when you believed, you were marked in him with a seal, the promised Holy Spirit, who is a deposit guaranteeing our inheritance.
我们听了真理的道，然后接受了耶稣以后，我们就得到圣灵的印记。
After we heard the message of truth, the gospel of our salvation, we are marked in him with a seal, the promised Holy Spirit.
有圣灵在我们里面。
We have the Holy Spirit in us.
保证我们一定可以得到天上的基业。
The Holy Spirit guarantees that we will be receiving inheritance from God.
所以呢，保罗就开始了今天我们这段经文的祷告。
So Paul started with a prayer.About this, the scripture for today.
告诉我们这些基督徒说，我们怎么样靠着神得能力来活出在这个地上的生活。
He urges all the Christians how we are going to depend on the Holy Spirit to live our life in this world.
我们可以学习怎么样有能力的侍奉呢？第一个是要兴盛我们的祷告生活。
So how do we learn to be empowered as we serve God? First, we need to prosper our prayer life.
第二个呢，我们要常常与执事与圣灵同工。
Second, we need to work together with the Holy Spirit.
第三个，我们要竭力追求认识神。
And third, we need to seek God diligently, to know God diligently.
好，第一个我们要来看就是怎么样可以兴盛我们的祷告生活。
First, how can we prosper our prayer life?
那我们来看一下保罗的榜样哦。
Let's look at the example of Paul.
在十六节他就说他不住的为他们祷告不住为他们感谢神祷告的时候常常提到他们
It says here in verse 16 I have not stopped giving thanks to God for you I remember you in my prayers
其实呢保罗曾经用三年的时间在以弗所传福音跟建造教会
Actually Paul spent 3 years in Ephesus preaching the gospel and also planting churches
所以呢，以弗所教会好像是他的孩子一样。
So the church in Ephesus is like his child.
所以他经历逼迫，现在保罗经历逼迫，然后被关在罗马的监狱里面。
He experienced being persecuted and he was put to prison in Rome.
可是他还是非常的关心以弗所教会。
But still he cares a lot for the church in Ephesus.
然后听到他们有好见证，有信心又有爱心，他就非常的感谢。
When Paul heard about the good testimonies of the Christians in church of Ephesus, he was filled with thanks.
其实以弗所教会是个乖孩子
哈。Actually, church in Ephesus is a good kid.
因为他们不像哥林多教会那么骄傲，然后结党纷争。
It's not the church is not like the church in
哥林多
in Corinth that is proud and also they form groups and fight each other.
他也不像加拉太教会一样。他们有律法主义的问题。
And it's different from the church in Galatia, wherein they experience the problem of legalism.
他们自以为义。
They thought they are righteous.
他们也不像哥罗西教会遇到什么异端。
And unlike the church in Colossae, where there was cults. And the church in Ephesus is a good church, a good kid.
It
seems that there's nothing else that Paul can pray for them.
But
Paul says, I'll never stop praying for you.
对这么一个乖孩子, 这么一个好教会, for, 保罗祷告了一个非常重要的祷告。
And for this good kid, for this good church, Paul prayed for this church. One very important thing about this. We know that Paul has a very thriving prayer life.
而且他呢, 常常在为别人代祷,
and he always intercedes for other people.
亲爱弟兄姐妹啊,
so dear brothers and sisters,
祷告是灵魂的呼吸。
Prayer is the breathing of the soul.
没有呼吸, 生命会死亡。
Without breathing, life ends.
那如果没有祷告呢, 灵魂会死亡。
Without prayer, the soul dies.
有一个牧师啊, 有一位 牧师啊，女的哈，牧师，她有一天呢，她辛苦的打扫他们全家哈。
Oh, so there's a lady pastor. One day she was working hard to clean up their house.
哎，第二天以后，她全身的关节开始肿起来，然后会痛。
But the following day, she found her joints swollen and achy.
那她就看医生，医生就说，哎呀，我觉得这个很像是类风湿性关节炎。
So she went to see a doctor. The doctor says, I think probably it is rheumatoid arthritis.
然后就把他转介到很大的医院去检查。
So she was transferred to a big hospital for further examinations and tests.
然后她经过了一连串的检查，还要再等一段日子才能够知道结果。
So she underwent a series of tests and examinations, and then she has to wait for a period of time for the result.
然后在这个等候的期间啊,
and during this waiting period,
她就开始去research，去了解到底什么叫做类风湿性关节炎。
So she searched online to see what this rheumatoid arthritis is about.
原来这种类风湿性关节炎是一种慢性的而且会不断的发展的关节性疾病。
Rheumatoid arthritis is a chronic illness that progresses slowly.
然后你全身的关节就会变形，然后就会一直疼痛。
To a point that joints of the body become deformed and then would be swollen and would be very painful. And there is no very effective treatment to this illness.
通常病人到第五年的时候呢，他就开始会那个就变成那个失能。
And usually when a patient suffering from this illness reaches the fifth year, all the joints in his body will become dysfunctional.
可能你没办法想象，那你的手举起来有很多关节，对不对？
Raise your hand. Imagine we have joints all over our hands, our bodies, our feet. So patients suffering from this kind of illness, he would experience pain all over the joints in his body. And then later on, this kind of people with this illness should have their joints replaced. A big sum of money is needed for the medical expenses.
他心里就越恐惧。
So that when the lady pastor knew about this illness, what are complications, the more she researched about this, the more she became afraid.
那他每一天都不断地在祷告。
So she prayed hard every day.
特别地求主来医治他。
And asked for God's healing. But deep in her heart, she doesn't have peace.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹啊, 我这边也要提醒你们,
brothers and sisters, let me remind you.
我们现在很快的可以在网络上获得一些资讯。
Probably we can search online for some information.
特别是有关什么COVID-19的知识。
Maybe
long COVID.
Information about COVID, long COVID.
我要鼓励你。
I'd like to encourage everyone.
不要依靠这些知识,
do not depend on this information that we search online. You have to trust the Lord.
很多人也告诉我这个 COVID-19有多么恐怖, 可怕。
Many people they shared about how horrible this virus is.
当我发现我女儿生病了，确诊了。
And then when my daughter was tested positive for COVID,
我又开始去research怎么照顾我女儿,
then I went to
保护我的全家,
do some research on how to protect our family, how to take care of my daughter.
可是你知道没有办法都很小心的。
But you know, it's really very, very hard to be absolutely careful.
有一天我说, 糟糕, 这个垃圾我忘记喷酒精了。
And then I said one day, I forgot to spray some alcohol in the garbage bag.
我的手又碰了其他东西了。
Oh, my hand touched something I'm not supposed to.
我的儿子们会不会感染啊?
Would my sons be infected also?
突然之间神就告诉我,
All of a sudden, God told me,
他说我保护你胜过酒精保护你。
You know, when I protect you, my protection is greater than the alcohol.
我每天还是有消毒的
of course I still disinfect I sterilize everything at home
可是那个惧怕跟那个不安就离开了
But this feeling of fear and what I call this a vegetative feeling just disappear because
你知道世界上的, after a prayer 世界上的知识啊资讯还有媒体的报道呢 不能带给我们平安
You know the information this world or knowledge from this world cannot bring us peace
可是我们花很多时间在这上面
But yet we spend so much time
然后这些东西就会被仇敌利用来欺骗我们 或是恐吓我们
And this knowledge, this information is usually They are usually used by our enemy, Satan, to intimidate us.
可是神的话可以带给我们平安, 我们却花很少的时间在读神的话。
You know, God's word can bring us peace, but we spend a very few time reading God's word.
好, 我们继续讲到这位牧师,
let's continue with the story of this lady pastor.
啊, 就是本来她带着这个不安, 啊, 在祷告。
So when at first she was praying with this uneasy feeling,
啊, 有一天她在运动的时候, 一边运动一边祷告,
so one time while she was doing her regular exercise and praying at the same time,
然后圣灵就很温柔地对她说话,
the Holy Spirit gently told her,
她说你的祷, 其实你祷告的焦点错了,
actually you're praying with the wrong focus.
她就说主啊, 那你要我怎么祷告?
But Lord, how should I pray then?
主跟她说, 你要祷告, 如何透过这次生病的过程, 让你的生命可以荣耀我
What you should be praying is Through this experience, this sickness How your life can glorify me
他说你现在这种反应跟那个没有耶稣住在生命里的人是一样的
You know, the reaction that you're showing is no different from someone who doesn't have Jesus in his heart
所以他就改变他祷告的焦点
So she started to change the focus of her prayer
不是只有祈求自己得医治
She didn't only ask for healing
她祈求说在这整件事上她的生命可以荣耀神
She prayed that through this entire experience How she can glorify God
她的生命就她突然哦她的真的就得到很大的平安
Suddenly she experienced peace A big peace that comes from God
几个礼拜后去看报告 她不是得到类风湿性关节炎
So weeks after she went to the doctor To see the report The result of the examinations It's not rheumatoid arthritis
只是因为关节老化造成发炎
It's just degenerative arthritis because of aging
啊, 弟兄姐妹, 我们很容易祷告的时候都集中在自己或是跟自己有关系的事上
Now you know when we pray most of the time We focus on ourselves and things that surround us
啊, 然后仇敌就会利用这世界上的媒体啊, 知识啊, 开始欺骗我们, 恐吓我们
And Satan would use the knowledge or information from the world From the social media to deceive us, to intimidate us
啊, 所以我们开始担心, 哎呀, 有战争了
And you started to become afraid Oh, there's war
哎呦, 通货膨胀啊
Oh, inflammation
No,
inflation, sorry, inflation
能源跟粮食短缺啊
Oh, energy and food shortage
这个新冠肺炎越来越严重又有变种病毒了
And the COVID virus is getting serious And new variants keep coming up
主啊, 保护我
Lord, help me, protect me
然后我把自己关在家里 不要出门了
I'm going to lock myself up in the room I'm not going to go out of the house I'm not going to attend the church service
主啊, 赶快让新冠肺炎停下来吧
Lord, please allow the COVID virus to stop
让所有的坏消息离开我 不要影响我们
bad news should not come and affect me
亲爱弟兄姐妹
So dear brothers and sisters
我不是说这样祷告是错的
I'm not saying that praying like this is wrong
但是这样祷告太小了
But this kind of prayer is too small
因为神想要提升我们 想要扩张我们
Because God wants to expand us and elevate us
我们是上帝的儿女
We are the children of God
我们的神天父是掌管宇宙万有的
Our heavenly Papa is in control of the entire world It is the entire universe
他容许战争地震饥荒
He allows with war, plague, famine
他甚至让新冠肺炎已经两年多了
He allowed COVID virus to exist in this earth for more than 2 years
因为在这些当中他仍然掌权
But despite all this, he's still in control
他永远是慈爱，永远是良善的。
He's always good. He's always kind.
他希望我们在这种环境当中被改变，被更新。
He wants us to be changed, to be transformed in this kind of environment.
我们不会再只看见自己的事。
And we will not be only focused to things concerning us.
我们开始愿意出来，让我们的生命可以被使用来荣耀神。
Then we will be willing to step out of our comfort zone so that our lives would be able to glorify God.
所以保罗被关在监狱里。
So when Paul was imprisoned,
他不能够跑到其他地方去。
He cannot go to other places.
他就开始为他所建立的教会祷告了。
He prayed for all the churches that he has planted.
然后他写信给他们。
And then he wrote letters to these churches.
你有没有看见保罗里面那个很兴盛的祷告生命啊？
Can you picture that vibrant, thriving prayer life that Paul has?
我们再来读一个经文哈。
Let's look at the passage.
以弗所书6章18节。
In Ephesians chapter.
他说要靠着圣灵，随时多方的祷告祈求，并要在此警醒不倦，为众圣徒祈求。
Ephesians chapter 6, verse 18, and pray in the Spirit at all occasions with all kinds of prayers and requests. With this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all the Lord's people.
你知道当圣徒祷告的时候，天使就开始动员起来了。
Do you know when when saints start to pray, believers start to pray, the angels in heaven are mobilized.
圣徒的祷告像香一样，它可以震动天地啊。
You know, the prayers of the believers, they are just like incense that could shake the heaven and earth.
我刚说的哈，都是在圣经有记载。
What I have told you a while ago are all recorded in the Bible.
但以理一祷告，天使就派出去，天使长就被派出去了。
When Daniel prayed, angels were being sent out.
然后天空就开始发生属灵征战了。
Spiritual battle happening in the atmosphere.
我们的神永远是得胜的那一方。
And you know our God is always the victor.
你知道你的祷告可以震动天地吗？
Do you know that your prayer can shake heaven and earth?
我们圣徒才是这世上真正的掌权者。
We, the believers, are the true rulers of this world.
的确，新冠疫情会影响我们生活，影响我们聚会。
Although COVID virus can affect us in some ways.
但是新冠病毒
meanings.
新冠病毒不能威胁我们的生命。
But COVID virus cannot threaten our lives.
不能够影响我们属灵的权柄跟能力。
Cannot affect our spiritual authority and power. Because we belong to God.
我们永远都是有平安，有救恩。
We have salvation and peace forever.
我们自有永生了。
And we have eternal life.
现在我们留在这里，因为我们是基督大使。
Right now we're still in this world living because we are the ambassadors of Christ.
我们是福音的见证人。
We are the witnesses of the gospel.
我们是教会跟万民的代祷者。
We are intercessors of the world and all nations.
我们就是教会。
But we are the church.
基督的身体。
We are the body of Christ.
我们透过祷告与那天上的资源连结。
We through prayer we are connected with heavenly resources.
我们透过祷告正在管理。
And we rule over the world through prayer. Especially brothers and sisters.
你们是从不同的地方来的。
You came from different places.
你们可以被称为列国的代祷者。
You can be referred to as intercessors of all nations.
因为我们有不同，我们有多元的文化背景。
Because we have different cultures and backgrounds.
神就是要使用我们。
And God wants to use us.
你是菲律宾的祝福，你也是台湾的祝福。
You are a blessing in the Philippines. You are also a blessing in Taiwan.
而如果你还是觉得忧愁跟恐惧。
If you still always feel afraid and worried at all times,
常常是因为你被仇敌欺骗跟恐吓。
That's because you are being deceived and intimidated by Satan, our enemy.
我们真的要学习。
We need to learn.
改变祷告的焦点。
Change the way we pray.
兴盛我们的祷告生活。
And prosper our prayer life.
跟神说，主啊，不要照我的旨意，要照你的旨意。
And tell God not according to what I want, but according to your will.
求你使用我的生命来荣耀你。
Please use my life so to glorify you.
求你引导我怎么活出神儿女的生命。
Please direct me so that I can live a life as your children.
祷告就是灵魂的呼吸。
Prayer is the breathing of the soul.
我们要努力兴盛自己的祷告生活。
We need to work hard to prosper our prayer lives.
你要天天透过灵修祷告跟神连接。
You have to be connected to God on a daily basis through your devotion, through your prayers.
你要开始起来关心你周围的人。
And care about people around you.
如果你周围有谁今天座位上没有来哈，
Especially people who are not here today, you can start to care for them.
你就开始为他祷告。
Pray for these people.
我们可以为菲律宾现在北部地震来祷告。
Pray for the victims of the earthquake in the northern part of the Philippines.
去参加小组, 在小组中一起祷告,
we joined a cell group and prayed with other
啊, 参加祷告会,
cell members. We joined a prayer meeting.
在教会中一起祷告,
and we prayed with other believers.
找祷告同伴,
and we asked for prayer partners.
跟祷告同伴一起祷告,
we prayed with our prayer partners.
你一定要想尽各样的方式,
you have to think of ways and means to pray, to prosper your prayer life.
学会怎么样运用你属灵的权柄跟能力。
Learn to use your spiritual power and authority.
所以我们从这段经文来学习怎么样做一个有能力的侍奉。
So from this scripture we learn how to be empowered in our service to God.
第一个就是要兴盛我们的祷告生活。First
we need to prosper our prayer life.
第二个呢, 第二个就是要跟圣灵同工。
Second is we have to work together with the Holy Spirit.
我们发现保罗做了这个很重要的祷告, 最重要的祈求就是求天父把圣灵赐给我们。
Paul made an important prayer, and that is to ask God to bless us with His Holy Spirit.
哎，我忘了做。好，十七节。
In verse 17, it says,
他说呢,
and ask the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the glorious Father, to give you the Spirit who will make you wise and reveal God to you, so that you will know Him.
他说呢，要求我们主耶稣基督的神，荣耀的父，将那世人智慧和启示的灵赏给我们。 那我们先来了解一下，从以下的经文我们没有一节一节去读哈，这个都从以下的经文啊所提出来的，就是这个圣灵的工作哈。So
from the passages below, it mentioned about the work of the Holy Spirit.
好，第一个呢，圣灵是世人智慧和启示的。First,
the work of the Holy Spirit gives wisdom and revelation.
啊，当神给我们智慧启示的时候，好像打开我们那个心里面的眼睛。When
God gives wisdom and revelation, it seems like the eyes of our hearts are open.
我们可以看见，我们可以领悟属灵的事情。
We can see and then we can understand spiritual things.
第二个，让我们可以明白真理跟活出真理。
And second, we can understand and live out the truth.
我们可以真的认识神。
We can truly know God.
我们可以知道神在我们生命当中的那个呼召。
We can truly understand the calling of God in our lives.
我们可以了解上帝能力有多么的浩大。
The power that is of God that is so great. And we know that Christ has the ultimate power in the entire world, in the entire universe, and everything falls under His feet. And then we have the Holy Spirit working in the church.
We
are the people called and chosen by God. And through the power of the Holy Spirit, we fulfill the Great Commission.
第三个，圣灵正在我们的教会还有我们个别基督徒生命当中运行。
The power of the Holy Spirit is at work in our church and also in the life of every Christian.
就是那个死人复活的能力现在正在我们里面运行，正在我们的教会里面运行。
The great power that raises the dead is the same power that is working in our church and in our individual lives.
所有万有都伏在基督的脚下。
And all things fall under the feet of Jesus Christ.
仇敌撒旦也伏在基督的脚下。
And even our enemy Satan falls under the feet of Christ.
我们已经有那个能力可以胜过罪和死亡。
And we have the power to overcome sin and death.
因为圣灵的运行，教会会充满神迹奇事。
Because of the work of the Holy Spirit and the church will be filled with miracles and wonders.
亲爱弟兄姐妹,
so dear brothers and sisters,
真的劝你好好的读圣经默想它。
I really encourage you to spend time reading God's word and think,
让你的祷告焦点转向神,
so that your focus would be diverted to God instead of yourself.
而不会只有看到自己的需要,
so that you would not only be seeing your own needs,
而不会一直在那个忧愁恐惧当中,
and falling the trap of fear and worry.
我们来读圣经, 使徒行传10章38节。
Let's read
神怎样以圣灵和能力膏拿撒勒人耶稣，这都是你们知道的。他周流四方行善事，医好凡被魔鬼压制的人，因为神与他同在。
Acts chapter 10 verse 38, it says how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power, how He went around doing good and healing all who were under the power of the devil because God was with Him.
你知道耶稣道成肉身来到这个世上,
you know, Jesus came to this world as a man.
他就跟我们一模一样了,
He's the same as
他怎么样在这世上行神迹呢?
Like us. How come He was able to perform miracles?
是神用圣灵加给他,
because God blessed filled Jesus Christ with the Holy Spirit.
圣灵与耶稣同在,
and the Holy Spirit was with Jesus.
所以他就可以, 他有能力, 行善事, 医好人, 医治人, 然后释放人。
That's why He has the ability and the power to heal the sick and also do perform good works.
Dry out demons.
And drive out demons.
然后呢，人家就看见耶稣有神的同在。
And then people see that Jesus is the presence of God.
同样的事情发生在我们身上。
Likewise, similar things happen to us.
当我们信耶稣以后
，the moment we become Christians,
神也是用圣灵和能力恩膏我们。
And God also anoint us with His power, His Holy Spirit.
所以我们已经被差遣，在
这个世上。That's why we are being sent out to this world.
就是要行善事
，to do good works.
啊，去要医治人
，to heal,
要释放人
，to release people,
要彰显出神的同在
，to show or manifest.God's presence in our lives.
你的生活，我们的生活就是服事。
You know, our lives are, is our life itself is a ministry.
我们的生活，我们的生活就是来服事神。
We live to serve God.
不是只有来到教会当中讲道啊，带敬拜才是服事神。你每一天的生活都是在服事神。
You are living a life every day that serves God. Now, service is not restricted only to the pulpit wherein you lead the worship or you attend the church service.
那我们的生命就是福音大能的见证。
You know, our life is the testimony of the power of the gospel.
台湾有一个基督徒姐妹叫做刘霞，她就得到类风湿性关节炎。
Christian lady called Liu Xia. She suffered from rheumatoid arthritis.
就是我们刚刚说到那个疾病。
You know the illness that we spoke about?
她12岁开始不能走路。
So she was not able to walk at age 12.
然后她全身的关节，全身哈，真的，全身的关节就开始肿起来，然后变形。
All the joints in her body were swollen and deformed.
她一生都在忍受那个关节疼痛。
She has spent her entire life suffering from this pain and agony.
止痛药也没有效。
Pain reliever seemed not to work.
她有一次是这个关节下颚关节变形。
One time she suffered from a deformation of her mandible.
所以她不能吃东西。
On her jaw. So she was unable to eat.
所以呢，还要开刀，好呢。
So they have to. She has to go through a surgery and have.Her jaw replaced.
可是她成为一个很有名的作家。
But she became a very famous author.
她出版了很多畅销书。
She has published several famous books.
她的手就是都肿起来变形的。
You know, imagine her hands are swollen and deformed.
那这就是用她那个变形的手夹着笔在写作。
She used her deformed hand in writing.
她生活是充满了痛苦的。
You know, imagine her life is a life of suffering.
可是他的作品却是很幽默的。
But all these literary works that she has done, they are very humorous.
啊，我也买了哈。
And actually, I bought some books that she wrote.
因为他读了以后，你会笑出来，你会很喜乐、有盼望的。
After you read the books that she wrote, the content is filled with hope, with joy.
他小学都没有毕业哈。
Imagine she didn't even finish elementary.
可是他很多次得到国家文学奖。
But she has received multiple times.The National Literary Award.
因为关节变形，她连坐着轮椅都很困难哦。
You know, imagine her body, all the joints in her body, were deformed, and so she find it very hard to sit down.
可是她成立了一个叫做伊甸残障基金会。
She established the foundation called Eden Foundation for the Disabled.
Okay. 然后呢，专门在帮助各种身心残障的人跟他们的家庭。
To help those people with similar problem like her and people with physical and mental disabilities and their families.
然后她创办各种事工。
And also she started many ministries.
有复健的事工，有教育的事工。
Ministries involving rehabilitation
啊，对，
然后 education
对，然后职业训练
，and also vocational training，
然后还设立工厂、农场、教会跟布道团
，and also started set up ministries in the farm, in the church, and also different missionary groups，
还有 factory 哈
，and also in the factory。
然后总统呢，请他去担任我们台湾的总统，请他担任国家顾问、国策顾问。
The president of Taiwan invited her to be a national A presidential advisor.
很多在世界上的人眼中看来，他们已经没有用、没有价值了。
There are some people in the world that we may look at this person and see that this is a useless person or worthless.
我以前也曾经觉得自己是一个 useless and worthless 的人。
I used to think of myself, consider myself useless and worthless.
可是当我的眼睛被打开以后
，But when my eyes were opened,
我真的开始活在。一个不同的领域里面
It seems like I'm living in a different realm
就像这位 刘霞女士一样
like this lady called 刘霞
当她接受耶稣以后
after she received Jesus Christ
就领受了圣灵
and she received the Holy Spirit
然后就开始每一天与圣灵同工
she started to live a life working together with the Holy Spirit
我们也是啊我们也是
we also have to live
然后圣灵就会给我们智慧和启示
the Holy Spirit would give us wisdom and revelation
让我们能够明白真理
so that we can understand the truth
然后给我们能力让我们可以活出这个真理
and give us the power and the strength to live out the truth that we know
我们知道要饶恕我们就有能力去饶恕
we know we need to forgiveWe will be given
the
strength to forgive. We know we should love.
我们就开始学着分享、
And、关心、祷告。We learn how to pray for other people, to love other people.
因为那是圣灵在我们里面工作。
Because this is the Holy Spirit working in us.
然后我们就经历上帝的大能。
And then we experience God's power.
哇，就很多神迹奇事发生在我们的生命当中。
And many wonderful things and miracles happen in our lives because of this.
最伟大的神迹就是我们的生命被改变。
And the biggest miracle is our lives are changed.
然后呢，就荣耀上帝。
And then we glorify God with our lives.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹啊
，So dear brothers and sisters,
我们要有能力的来侍奉神。第一个要兴盛我们的祷告生活。
In order for us to be empowered to serve God, first we need to prosper our prayer life.
第二个，我们要过着一个随时与圣灵同工同行的生活。
Second, we have to live a life that works together with the Holy Spirit.
第三个，我们要竭力追求认识神。
And third, we have to seek to know God diligently.
啊，这个在十七到十九节哈，不用念。
In verses 17 to 19，
不用念哈，就说他呢，保罗祷告说，他求神荣耀的父，让我们可以真知道他。
And Paul asked the glorious Father to let us know, truly know him.
然后呢，照明我们心中的眼睛。
And open the eyes of our hearts.
让我们可以知道他的恩召有多么伟大。
So that we can understand how great his calling is.
好，让我们知道他在我们生命当中会显出很大的能力。
And then that a great power will be revealed in us.
然后他集中在让我们要知道，要认识神，要知道真理。
To know God, to know the truth.
我大学时代从台南南部到台北来念书
So I'm in, basically from Tainan and came to Taipei during college
然后那时候住在六个人一间的宿舍里面
I was living in a dorm with six people in the room
那我就很认真念书为了要申请奖学金
I studied very hard so that I can get my scholarship
然后呢我就去找攻读的机会要打工赚钱
I looked for places where they hire students part-time jobs that I can earn money
可是我们班上同学
But you know, there are some classmates in our class.
有好几位，他们是每一天是开着车，
Several of them,
开车来上学。
They drive themselves to school with a luxurious car.
然后他们家里他还没有毕业，他就已经有房子了。
Their parents bought a house for them, even though they're still studying.
然后呢，他们毕业以后很快就开了自己的公司了。
So after graduation, they opened their own companies.
因为他有个有钱的爸爸。
Because they have rich fathers.
可是现在我们已经有了天父爸爸了。
But right now, remember, we have our heavenly Papa.
你知道，你有了爸爸，你就有了一切。
And when you have the heavenly Father, you have everything.
因为天父一切都是你的。
Because what belongs to the heavenly Father belongs to you.
你所有的也都是他的。
Whatever belongs to you also belongs to him.
好，你的问题、你的责任、你的健康，通通都是神的。
Your health, your problems belong to God also.
所以现在不要再害怕了。
That's why you should not be afraid anymore.
那可是我们看不见神啊
But we cannot see God.
我们到底要怎么认识他
So how are we supposed to know him?
神让我们认识他
The Lord allow himself to be known.
神非常希望我们认识他
He desire for us to know him.
他透过启示让我们认识他
Through revelation that we come to know God.
我们越认识神就会越有信心
The more we know God, the stronger our faith becomes
那如果越有信心就越会经历神
The more we have faith, the more we experience God
圣经上说你若信就必看见神的荣耀
And the Bible says if you have faith, you see the glory of God
我记得我的小孩刚开始进去我们本来都在家自学后来小孩开始进去学校去上学
When my children started to go to school
那我就开始为他们祷告
I pray for them
然后有一天在我祷告当中神就跟我说你求的事情太小了
One time when I was praying for my kids the Holy Spirit reminded me that you know your prayer is too small
好我就开始把全班的名单拿来就开始为全班祷告
And then I pray for all the students in my kids' classroom
那后来我就发现有几个基督徒家长
And then later on, I found out there are some Christian parents in the class.
啊，所以我们就起来成为一个代祷团队，专门来为学校祷告。
So we form a group primarily to pray for the church, for the school.
然后神就一直拓展我们的祷告领域。
And God has been expanding the scope of our prayer.
我们就为全国性的祷告考试来祷告。
And we pray for all the students in their national board exam.
我们为教育祷告。
We pray for the educational system in Taiwan.
我们在校园当中就举办了一个高举神的祷告会。
We have a prayer, big prayer meeting, exalting God in the campus.
然后我们在那里祝福全校。
And we bless all the students in the campus.
那学校的校长就信主受洗了。
And you know, finally the principal of the school became a Christian and she was baptized.
然后基督徒老师就得到国家的教育大奖。
And the teachers in the school, they receive an award. From the government.
本来学校里面有学生跟老师对立的情况就化解了。
You know, sometimes, and also the conflicts between teachers and students were resolved.
然后有一些邪恶的权势本来想进到校园，他就被拦阻了。
You know, those forces of the dark forces from outside that intend to enter the premises of the school was stopped.
然后呢，学生团契在这个校园里面，学生团契从各位数到几十个哈。
You know, the fellowship in the campus started with a few people become
到几个？差不多三四十个吧。
30 to 40members.
啊，有很多人呐、啊，很多孩子哈、啊，这个学校的孩子受洗。
Many
children 加入教会。
Were baptized and joined the church.
我们来读一下圣经。
So let's look at the Bible.
啊，在约翰福音十一章四十节。
Next.
耶稣说：“我不是对你们说过吗？你若信，就必看见神的荣耀。”
And Jesus said, "Did I not tell you that if you believe, you will see the glory of God?"
我们越认识神，信心就会越大。
The more we know God, the bigger our faith becomes.
你知道，认识神不是只有对神的知识。
You know, when we say we know God, it's not limited to only knowing God in our head.
啊，我知道神慈爱。
I know God is good. I know God is just.
我知道神是创造者。
I know that God is my creator.
非常的好。
Very good.
可是不只是这样。
But not only so.
因为神很渴望我们跟他亲近。
Because God longs to be close to us.
啊，让我们很了解认识。
So that we can know him in a very personal, intimate way.
你敢跟他祷告，你敢靠近他。
You can come close to him and pray to him.
啊，虽然神是个灵，我们的肉体的眼睛好像看不见。
God is a spirit, and although we cannot see him with the naked eye,
可是他已经赐给我们圣灵。
But he has already given us the Holy Spirit.
圣灵就会给我们智慧和启示。
The Holy Spirit gives us wisdom and revelation.
让我们可以跟神建立那个
亲近的关系。So that we can connect with God in an intimate basis.
我们可以了解有关神的事，明白他的心意。
We can understand things about God. We can understand His will.
我们可以跟神有情感上的互动。
We can have a close interaction with the Holy Spirit.
有一个姐妹哦，她成为基督徒以后
，a sister after she became a Christian.
啊，因为她是一个服装设计师哈
，so she is a fashion designer.
啊，她想到自己当助理的时候非常辛苦，所以她就很用心的对待她的助理。
Because she used to suffer a lot as an assistant when she was younger. So right now she'sworking very hard to be nice to her assistant.
啊，她对她非常好，很信任她。
She trusted her assistant and treated her very well.
可是没有想到这个助理竟然背叛她，抢她的订单。
Unexpectedly, this assistant of hers betrayed her and took her clients.
然后呢，在别人面前毁谤她。
Even destroyed her reputation.
但他知道以后就非常的痛苦。
So this lady Christian was very sad after knowing this.
特别当我们很真心的去付出，然后被背叛的时候，那心里真的非常的痛苦哦。
I think we can identify with this lady Christian when we are nice to someone and that person betrays you.
他在神面前来祷告，他说：“天父，你有没有看见我被伤害的这么深
？”And she prayed, Lord, did you see what she did to me? That I'm injured all over.
你还要我像耶稣一样去饶恕他吗
？You still want me to forgive this person？
我宁愿不要这个信仰。
I don't want this faith anymore。
就在他祷告当中哦。
And then during her prayer，
其实他已经哭泪流满面了。
She was crying already because of this。
他眼睛已经充满泪水了。
And her eyes were filled with tears。
可是他竟然看见了，看见耶稣挂在十字架上。
But then she saw the vision of Jesus Christ kneeling on the cross。
耶稣全身都是鞭伤
，multiple injuries on the body of Jesus as a result of the whipping。
身上没有一块好的皮肤。
She doesn't, he doesn't have a good flesh anymore.
那头上还带着荆棘冠冕。
The flesh are torn apart.
那个血都这样子流下来。
He was wearing a thorn of a crown of thorn, and then blood oozing.
手脚挂在十字架上。
And then his hands and feet nailed on the cross.
然后当耶稣要呼吸，他必须这样，然后这个手就摩擦伤口，手脚的伤口就要摩擦。
Every time he takes a deep breath, there will be friction on the nail on his nailed hands and feet.
可是耶稣在这么痛苦当中，还是看着他。
And then in such agony, Jesus look at this lady Christian.
跟他说：“孩子，我爱你。”
And Jesus says, "You know, kid, I love you."
把你的痛苦全部交给我。
Give all your pain to me.
让我来担当你所有的痛苦。
Let me shoulder your pain.
他说他真的就是哭倒在非常的感动
and
非常的难过倒在那个十字架下面
designer, cried the feet of Jesus
他说主耶稣请你原谅我
Lord Jesus Christ please forgive me
那从这一次以后看到耶稣以后他的祷告改变了
From this encounter she changed the way she prayed
他说主啊我感谢那些不断在我背后毁谤我的人
Lord I thank those who destroyed my reputation
让我看见我有很多功课可以学习
Because I came to know that there are a lot of things that I need to learn
亲爱的天父我感谢你给我很多恩典让我可以分享出去
Lord thank you for the grace and blessings that you have given me that are so much that I can share with other people
主耶稣我非常感谢你这么爱我
I thank you Lord for loving me this much
你可以担当我所有的痛苦
That you're willing to shoulder all my pain
我感谢你因为上帝的爱跟祝福是没有人可以夺走的
I thank you for your love and your blessing is something that no one can take away from me
亲爱的弟兄姐妹
So dear brothers and sisters
我们必须认识我的神
We should know our God Your God
必须认识神
We have to know our God
你的眼光
The way
你的祷告
Your prayer
你的生命都会改变
Your life would be changed because of this
我们来看一下约翰福音十七章三节是下一个经文
Next slide please
他说呢认识你独一的真神并且认识你所差来的耶稣基督这就是永生
In John chapter 17 verse 3 it says Now this is eternal life that they know you the only true God and Jesus Christ whom you have sent
认识神
Knowing God
就是永生
is eternal life
那是我们跟神之间那种独一无二的关系
This is a one and onlyunique relationship we have with God
因为耶稣特别为你
Jesus specially
为你成就救恩
fulfill the work of redemption for you
为你承担所有的痛苦
He shouldered all your pain
为你祷告让圣灵可以住在你里面
We pray that the Holy Spirit would reside in us
神也差遣圣灵来
And God has already sent his Holy Spirit
打开我们的眼光
To open our eyes
我们是被拣选的
To know that we are chosen
我们是圣洁没有瑕疵的
We are holy and blameless
我们现在是天父的孩子
We are the children of God
我们是在地上真正的掌权者
We are the true rulers of this world
认识神
Know God
求神帮助我们认识他
May the Lord help us to know him more
我们学习怎么样有能力的来侍奉
So we learn how to be empowered in our service to God first
要兴盛我们的祷告生活
We need to prosper our prayer life
第二个要时时与圣灵同工
Second we have to work together with the Holy Spirit at all times
第三个我们要竭力的追求认识神
And third, we have to diligently seek to know God
我们一起来祷告
Let's pray
亲爱弟兄姐妹我要邀请你
Dear brothers and sisters I would like to invite you
现在是你跟神的时间
Now is the time between you and God
你要放下所有的一切来到神面前
You have to set aside everything
你可以学习像保罗的祷告
And learn to pray like Paul
你来感谢神
Thank God
谢谢你把圣灵赏给我
Thank God for the Holy Spirit
谢谢你让我有智慧启示
Thank God for giving you wisdom and revelation
求你现在就帮助我
Ask the Holy Spirit to help you.
你已经打开我属灵的眼睛。
Open your spiritual eyes.
我要遇见你。
So that you can encounter him.
我要听见你。
See him, hear him.
我要经历你。
Experience him.
那在这个时候，我鼓励你开声祷告。
I want you to open your mouth and pray God.
怎么样兴盛祷告生活
？So how can you prosper your prayer life?
抓住每个机会祷告。
Take every opportunity you have to pray to God.
圣灵正在我们教会运行
The Holy Spirit is at work in His church
天父很喜悦很希望我们更靠近他认识他
The Holy Spirit longs for us to be close to Him longs for us to be talking to him.
我鼓励你开声祷告。
And I encourage you to open your mouth and pray to God.
来感谢, 如果你不知道祷告什么, 就开始感恩, 感谢神,
if you don't know how to pray,
感谢天父的恩典,
or what to pray, you start with thanking God for His blessing, for His grace.
感谢圣灵常常感动你, thank you, 引导你,
the Holy Spirit for always guiding you, directing you. For those who are experiencing heavy burdens among us,
it's
stopping you from praying. Bring all your heavy burdens to the Lord. Jesus extends his hand and says, give me all your burdens. Jesus is using his nail-pierced hand to shoulder all your burdens.
你放心地把所有的重担交给他。
Just entrust all your burden to him.
我鼓励你向神说, 主啊, 我不问为什么。
I encourage you to pray like this. Lord, I'm not going to ask why.
我要完全地降服于你。
I want to completely trust your heart.
主啊, 我不要问怎么办。
I'm not going to ask you how this problem is going to be solved.
我就是要完全地信任你。
I just want to completely trust in you.
我要感谢你,
and I thank you, Lord.
我要敬拜你,
I want to worship you.
亲爱主圣灵,
Holy Spirit,
我要顺服你,
I want to obey you.
求你天天来引导我,
please come and direct me every day.
求你充满我,
please fill me every day.
如果你渴望圣灵充满, 你可以把你的手, 向上,
if you long for the filling of the Holy Spirit,
就好像你要承接,
you can,
你要接住什么样,
raise your hand and ask from God.
手掌打开,
open your hand and ask from God.
让圣灵可以, 你就是在领受, 领受圣灵的能力, 圣灵的充满,
power and filling of the Holy Spirit from above.
圣灵要开始, 圣灵在我们当中工作, 哈, 你打开你的手来接受它,
you can open, 不用担心, lift up your hand and open your palm and allow the Holy Spirit to come.
弟兄姐妹神要使用你成为祝福
Brothers and sisters, God wants to use you
不只是祝福你,
as a conduit for His blessing.
祂要祝福你的家人,
He wants to bless you, bless your family, your entire household.
神要使用你,
God wants to use you to bless your workplace.
神要使用你, 祝福社会, 祝福国家。
God wants to use you to bless the society, to bless the country.
那你向神祷告, 神啊, 求你兴盛我的祷告生活。
Pray to God that, Lord, please prosper my prayer life.
你跟神立约, 说, 主啊, 我愿意每一天花什么时间, 多少时候来祷告。
Make a commitment with God. Lord, I'm willing to come to you in prayer every day. 父, we come to your presence. We thank you. We thank you for giving us the Holy Spirit. And Holy Spirit, how we love your presence. How we love to experience you working in our lives, Lord. Continue to be at work in us, Lord. Pray that you would give us wisdom and revelation from above, Lord, as we journey through life together with our many struggles, many heartaches, many problems. Lord, as we go through life in making important decisions, big and small, Lord, we come to your presence, Lord, and ask for you, Lord. Whatever our circumstances are, Lord, we ask, Lord, for your involvement, Lord, for your direction, for your guidance, because we know we cannot do it alone, Lord. And apart from you, we are nothing. Lord, continue to work in us. Speak to us. I pray, Father, ignite in us a fire that desires to be with you, to talk to you on a regular daily basis. Lord, I pray, Father, every time we come to your presence, reveal your desire, Lord, reveal your will to us, Lord, and give us an obedient heart, Lord, not to be always asking why and how and how things going to be, but Lord, fully trust in your heart, knowing that you know what's best for us. You have the best intention and you love us so much that you will not withhold anything good from us, Lord.
Amen.
Lord, we continue to, Lord, to rely on you, Lord. May you continue to fill us with your Holy Spirit. Humble us, Lord. Always, Lord, give us the desire, Lord, to be in connection, in close relationship with you, Lord.
Amen.
Lord, I would spend time talking to you instead of browsing the internet and looking at our Facebook. But Lord, we spend more time talking to you. Spend time, Lord. And Lord, be immersed in your word and let your word come alive in our lives, in our hearts, Lord, that we be able to glorify you and be truly, Lord, be the light and salt of this world. We thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Let's all rise.
May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in Him. May you overflow with hope and be empowered by the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen. Please take your seats.
Thank you for the word that we have received today. May God continue to speak to our hearts that we, His children, will have a prayerful life. And remind po, 11 o'clock, we'll start our equipping class. The topic will be the letter of Ephesians up to 2 o'clock this afternoon. And let us rise and let us sing our song.
I love you with the love of the Lord. I can see in you the glory of my King. Yes, I love you with the love of the Lord.
God bless everyone.